Hello friend, myself Pokhar Kareshmi from JSPM Bhimrabai Sound Polytechnic, Head of Electrical Engineering Department. Today we are going to conduct our practical in the course subject Industrial AC Machine, which belongs to third year diploma in Electrical Engineering, and our experiment number is 11 and our title is Perform the Direct Loading Test on the given alternator and determine the regulation at different power factor loads. We are already seen the title, means we have to conduct direct load test on given three phase alternator and determine voltage regulation for various power factor loads. So for this purpose we are using different power factor loads like resistive, capacitive and inductive load. Here practical significance is given, means alternator is widely used in a generating station, as in industry or as auxiliary power supply, so that we have to necessary to determine voltage regulation. The relevant program outcomes is a PO2, means discipline knowledge. Student will able to apply electrical field of electrical engineering knowledge in daily day-to-day practice, experimental practice, and PSO to test and maintain the various electrical equipment. In this case we are using three phase alternator, so we are already very familiar about the alternator. Now theoretical background is minimum required for this practical. We know that the voltage regulation up and voltage regulation down. Regulation is defined as the rise in voltage when full load is removed, means when we are remove the load, the voltage accordingly at the terminal goes on increases. So percentage voltage regulation up means E0 means no load voltage minus V, rated voltage, load voltage divided by V. And regulation down is same formula, but here is E0 minus V upon E0. The regulation up and down calculation are afterward we are seen after taking the reading. E0 is a no load induced EMF of alternator and V is a rated terminal voltage of alternator. Circuit diagram is shown here. Bipolar DC 230 volt DC is connected to DC shunt motor. Here DC shunt motor is coupled to alternator. Alternator is excited by separately excitation, field excitation, and accordingly the armature star connected. This is the alternator field winding connection and this is the alternator armature connection, and at the output of armature load current and load voltage measurement, we are connected ammeter, AC ammeter and AC voltmeter, and a three phase balance load is applied at the armature armature terminal box. Then the resources required: three phase alternator with shunt exciter, means we have to alternator with excitation, DC shunt motor for the prime mover purpose, exciter means separate excitation voltage required, ammeter MI type ammeter, here 0 to 10 ampere ammeter, PMMC 0 to 20 ampere, voltmeter MI type 0 to 300 volt for the measuring voltage, voltmeter PMMC type 0 to 300 and rheostat. So in detail next page, starter for DC motor for starting purpose, three phase balance resistive load, three phase balance inductive load and three phase balance capacitive load. So practically is slightly lengthy, but we are note down any four consecutive reading of out of these two loads and determine the voltage regulation and plot the nature of graph, means load current versus terminal voltage, means this is the IL versus VT graph we have to plot. From the graph, theoretically graph, it is clear that this is the ideal voltage line, and for resistive load means power factor is unity, as the load current increases, the load terminal voltage slightly decreases. For inductive load, the voltage drop ratio is slightly increases, and for capacitive load the voltage increases from its the rated values. Hence power factor is 0.8 leading, unity and lagging. The graphical nature is looking after the plotting characteristics. Here is the observation of synchronous speed of alternator. Here four pole alternator is given. Frequency is 50 Hz. So synchronous speed is NS is equal to 120 F upon P. 120 into 50 upon 4. By simplifying this, we are getting alternator synchronous speed 1500. Field current of alternator is given on terminal nameplate is 1.2 ampere. Rated terminal voltage is given as 440 volt. But by performing during performing this practical, we are maintaining near about 0.9 ampere field current reading and 230 volt armature output. These are the practical values for the more safety purpose. For resistive load, absorption table is load current means IL ampere, terminal voltage volt, and regulation is calculated according to the regulation up and down formula. So here load current IL and terminal voltage V, these are the measurable quantities while performing the practicals. Similarly, for the inductive load, same parameters, load current versus terminal voltage. Now we are going to start our practical. So first of all, make the connection as per the circuit diagram. Here DC series, DC shunt motor connection is seen here. The green wire is given to positive is a line, then armature and field. This is the 3-point starter, and accordingly DC shunt motor connection are done. Then armature is RYBN and this is the field. Here armature is connected to directly here for inductive load, and here the R and in between R and Y phase voltmeter is connected, and in series with blue phase we are connected series ammeter 0 to 2 ampere. And in this way the load arrangement means we have to plot taken the reading, load current and terminal voltage. These are the reading taken and write down in the observation table. Here auxiliary DC power supply is required for the field excitation, and these are the taken from the single phase demostrator. AC to DC converted, and this DC is given to field of the armature alternator winding, and excitation current is being shown here by this DC ammeter. This is the DC current supplying, and hence DC ammeter record the DC current. Firstly, switch on the main supply, then accordingly here we are on the multimeter, then start the DC rectifier. Here check the RY and BR voltage. It is looking normal in condition. Then on the rectifier head, start the DC on supply. Here rectifier DC output is getting here, regulated DC output. Then switch on the DC main unit, DC supply board. Now from this supply here, now supply is reaching in the control panel of DC shunt motor and alternator. Now we are starting the control panel main switch and move gradually the handle of the DC shunt motor in a forward direction. Now in this alternator coupled with DC shunt motor gets started. Now handle is at its maximum position, and the DC shunt motor as a prime mover runs the alternator. Now here DC excitation is here. Now start the auxiliary unit of rectifier, and here now gradually increase the voltage. And note down the excitation accordingly. when we are going to increase our excitation voltage from the single phase source, excitation voltage becomes increases, and here we are taken as a 0.9 is our the excitation to field. Now at this the field excitation is up to the 3.25 ampere, and accordingly excitation is at 280 volt. Here terminal voltage of the alternator is at 280 volt. Now here we are not giving any load, so load current is here. Now switch on the load here. Switch on the load. First reading is current is a 0.4, terminal voltage is a 275. Here is a maximum reading of 0.8 ampere is the load current. Accordingly the terminal voltage is shown here 232 volt, and by decreasing now load current is 0.7. load current is 0.7 here. 0.7 is the load current. Accordingly the terminal voltage is 238 volt is the terminal voltage. Now load current is 0.6. load decreases, and accordingly the terminal voltage is 240 volt. Now load current is 0.5 ampere, terminal voltage is near about 120 above. Here one digit is 2 volt, means 144 unit is the terminal voltage. Slightly decreases, 0.2 is the no load first reading, and at that time the terminal voltage is seen here 120 above. 4 digit passes, means 128 into 256 is the voltage reading. Now excitation becomes 0, then first switch off the load bank. When load bank is switched, accordingly the terminal voltage is decreased, and the output supply becomes shut down. Then first of all shut down the main supply, switch off the main supply. Accordingly the switch on the DC on main supply here, and then switch off the rectifier unit taken for the DC motor supply. Here DC motor supply becomes off, and in this way the practical reading is recorded. Now in second stage, student or we are taken, instead of inductive load we are taken capacitive load, we are taken resistive load, and plot the record the reading in the observation table, and plot the load current versus terminal voltage characteristics in graph.
Here we are taken inductive load reading. So inductive load current reading write down in this column 0, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6 onwards, and accordingly terminal voltage write down here. As the load increases, load current increases and terminal voltage becomes decreases. Same process is repeated for the resistive load, and write down the reading for the observation table. Accordingly same process is repeated for the capacitive load, and write down the reading in the observation table. And now calculation part. The obtained reading is plotted in the graphical manner, means load current versus IL versus terminal voltage, and this is the our baseline, means we have taken a 230 volt this line, and plot the point here as per the inductive load 0.8 lagging, the points are somewhere like this in the characteristics, and procedure repeated for the resistive load and procedure repeated for the capacitive load. By using the regulation up and regulation down formula, E0 minus V means E0 is, we know that E0 is, we are taken 230 volt, and accordingly the calculation is done and calculate the regulation of the alternator. In this way we are conducting and performing our experiment number 11. From the results and conclusion, it is clear that for the capacitive load the regulation is negative, for the resistive and inductive load regulation is the positive. Means as the load increases, terminal voltage increases for the capacitive load, but at in case of resistive and inductive load, as load increases, terminal voltage decreases, and this effect is majorly seen as the dropping ratio of the voltage by load current. As load increases, terminal voltage decreases in case of inductive load. So inductive load, resistive load and capacitive load and its regulation is seen in this experiment. So here, well, our experiment number 11 is over. Thank you very much.